In my senior year of high school, my friends and I wanted some sort of way to remember our last year together at the same school in a very special way. We got together and decided to make a documentary of senior year, recapping every major event that happened throughout the year, and give everyone the chance to share their perspective. I hope to look back on this video years from now and see how much fun we had as friends before we all went our separate ways. This is senior year.
I'm not keeping that.
So, what's your name?
Dude, we should add
a table. It's so weird.
Add a table with like a drink on the side of it.
Wait, put it down real quick, just see it. Make sure it stays.
It's in it.
Let go. No, I know what I need to get.
Nate and the one person.
God, yes. Put it right here.
Now, this way.
This way.
A little more. Oh, yeah, right there, right there.
Yeah,
there. Yo!
Okay, all right, I'm gonna do it.
My name is Nate Cradaville. I go to Canon High School.
I'm Matt Burnside. I'm a senior at Canon High School.
What's up? I'm Jake Bowman. I'm a senior at Canon High School.
My name is Harrison Williams.
I don't know.
Just be like, yo, what's up? I'm Harrison Williams.
I'm Harrison Williams.
I got a big in the finger. All
right, what's up? I'm Matt.
Your full name?
Matthew Jennings.
I'm Matt.
Matthew Jennings.
I'm Jack Creighton. I go to Canon High School.
You gotta introduce yourself.
Yeah, be like, what's up? I'm Tommy Barrow.
Hey, this is Tommy Barrow.
Hello, my name's Tommy Barrow. I'm a senior at Canon High School.
My name's Jack Mulligan.
Yosh.
Do I gotta clap?
No, I already clapped the audio.
All right.
I need to. Starting off with week one, we had Pitbull and the very first football game in like 2.5 years.
Pitbull was probably the best concert I had been to before Firefly.
Yeah, that was super fun. All of us went to our first concert in a while. It was awesome.
I just remember like going to Pitbull after like a soccer game or something like that, and there being like thousands of people there.
There were about 15,000 people there. All high school kids.
Hey, that you came here with someone, so why are you here in my arms? Oh!
Who the f*** is this?
All right, Tommy's episode. Pitbull, I could not go because my mom would not let me, so I heard it was the best thing ever.
My name is Jack Haley, aka Hot Sauce. Week one, Pitbull. Was matter of fact, my first concert I ever went to. It was insane. Fumbled the bag as I usually do, but
during the time, like, you know, concerts and everything weren't really starting back up again, so having that many people there was kind of like a crazy feeling, since people were like starting to come back out of their houses and things like that. So that was pretty awesome. I'm just gonna skip week two. We had his White Lies party, so he kind of threw it at like his co-worker's house, which was kind of weird.
Is that his co-worker's guest house? Just a random party to be at, but it was super fun.
So we all had like lies written on our shirts. Mine was, I get so obviously that's a lie.
Week three, another football game.
It was a neon game.
Week three, neon game. 80 Gray dropped one of the most fire videos I've ever seen.
Baby, it's amazing I'm in this space with you. I just can't crack your code. One day you're screaming, you love me loud. The next day you're so cold. One day you're here, one day you're there. One day you care, you're so unfair. Sipping from your cup till it runneth over. Holy grail.
Blue told me, remind you niggas. Fuck that shit y'all talking about. I'm the nigga. Caught up in all these lights and cameras. But look what that shit did to Hammer. God damn it, I like it. Bright lights enticing. But look what it did to Tyson. All that money in one night. 30 mil for one fight. As soon as all that money blows, all opinions take flight.
I didn't like the neon game, mainly because my head hurt the entire time. And, oh, and then I threw a party after, and the party was awesome.
Oh, okay. My personal favorite, because of sentimental value, is the neon game. I went and filmed the pregame, and went over and filmed the football game and the student section. Ended up being like one of my favorite videos ever made, and apparently everybody else liked it because it's easily one of the most viewed things that I've ever made. Moving on.
My name's Jack Creighton. I'm a senior at Canon High School. The Firefly. Firefly is probably the best time of my life so far.
Then Firefly, best week ever.
Yeah, Firefly.
That was probably the best time of my life. It was about 12 of my best friends, a bunch of guys just camping out at a music festival.
DJs were amazing. Yo, Wiz Khalifa, all that. I fell in love with Cage the Elephant.
The best concert was probably Cage. They're my favorite. Also, that's where I discovered Nate. What was that one band?
Oh, Hippie Sabotage.
Yeah, I discovered Hippie Sabotage, and Nate kept playing them over the speaker. I fell in love with them from there.
Can I start right now?
Give me one sec.
All right. Week 4, Firefly. Pretty lit. I actually was not there.
We drove up in Riley Armbruster's van. Realized the lot was about 5 feet wide with 12 guys, so it was a tight squeeze.
We had these like two lots rented, and we were expecting it to be like a pretty decent amount of space. But when we got there, there was like no space at all. We kind of had to like puzzle piece our campsite together in order to make it work. And all while it was literally pouring rain outside.
Friday, I got there late for Murder Beast, and that was it. That was when I first got there. I was like, this is gonna be insane.
Yo, what's up? My name's Nathaniel.
I wake up and I'm on like one of the shuttles. And, no, but I get woken up by this lady who's like, hey, if you don't get off on the next one, we're gonna have to like kick you off.
Saturday was a great lineup, and I saw none of them.
The concerts ended up being like really, really fun. All concerts from like Tame Impala, like Hippie Sabotage, The Killers, saw Murder Beats live. Murder Beats is f***ing crazy. Not because like he was necessarily like a great performer or anything, but because where we saw him was so sick. There were still like hundreds of people in this like tiny area in the woods. Everybody would spread out into this massive mosh pit led by Jack Haley.
My favorite was probably Murder Beats. I'm sure most of the guys said that like I started a lot of the mosh pits and all that. I did.
Bowman and I went to find one of my brother's friends that's older than us. As we're passing them, we saw these people that were definitely high. Like really f***ing high. But we're passing them and they have this massive slip and slide out. At this point, we're already like super wet because it had been raining like the entire day. Decided to ask him if we could hit the slip and slide. So there's this clip with Bowman and I on the first day, sliding across the slip and slide with these people.
Next homecoming.
Homecoming was super weird.
It was actually my first HOCO. Like I didn't go to any of the other HOCOs other than that one. That was my first HOCO the senior year.
Homecoming. Super dumb. Because of COVID, they usually put it in the cafeteria, but this year they decided to put it in like this kind of like outdoor part in a tent. Another thing, Matt and who was the other girl that won Homecoming King and Queen? That shit was definitely rigged.
I totally got robbed of Homecoming King. I would just like to point that out, that the school is corrupt and they rigged the Homecoming election. Anyway, I threw another party after that. It's going to be a recurring instance. Lots of parties at my house.
Hang out for a little bit and then...
basketball season. I think the games were better than the football game.
We weren't allowed to have a student section, but since each player, all the cheerleaders, all the coaches get 4 tickets, like that's kind of giving us a lot of wiggle room.
Obviously a smaller area, so although there's like a smaller number of people, it's much louder.
So same with football. Now we're in a gym where everybody can hear everything you say.
Okay, student section was awesome. I was front row, obviously. We ended up getting shut down by the school because we were too rowdy.
Whereas that school started getting pissed off because they'd lose or they'd go to shoot foul shots and our entire student section would talk shit to them the entire time.
For instance, the Parkside game. After the game, we beat them. It was a close game. One of the kids, when they were shaking hands, came over to the sideline. And they shoved Tristan Ridgeway like back into the student section and everybody had to hold him apart. It was almost like a big fight.
Tristan, dude, where are you at? Tristan here is a brawler. He totally grounded pound and beat the shit out of him. He went to the hospital.
Cambridge South Dorchester, where by the end of the game, we had one of their guys ejected.
You can say what he said.
He walked off the court and I'm not even exaggerating. This was what he quoted. Suck my dick, bitch, to the student section. After that, our student section got pretty limited.
Talk about the CSD game too.
Oh, down like the whole
time. Oh, dude, Pud. Pud.
How did we win there?
Because I had 25 points.
No, because of him.
Shut your mouth.
The plan was for the guards to come up and then to throw it to half court. Or they covered Aaron, so I got the ball in half court, and there's like 4 seconds left, and I was like, holy fuck, like, I'm gonna have to take the shot.
I'm not gonna lie, you were bringing the ball down, and I was like, dude, like, he has to shoot this ball, like, no one's open.
Yeah. So I dribble around half court, pull up the 3-point line, and I'm not setting up for a 3-pointer, so I just do a floater. Yeah dude, that. How did that go in?
No, dude, I was standing right under the basket when he shot it. When he shot it, I was like, holy fuck, he really just made that.
My face goes pale. I was like, I can't believe that just happened.
Where's my topics at? Legit. Getting an outline for the video. Am I missing anything?
No, dumbass.
What's up? I'm Chris Franzek. New Year's Eve. So awesome, dude.
Tristan's New Year's Eve party.
New Year's is pretty wild.
This is always the best party of the year when Tristan throws this.
But New Year's, I mean, it was awesome. I mean, we were jamming to songs. We were dancing the whole night. We were just going crazy. I mean, Tristan's house got trashed. That was awful. I feel terrible for that. It was just dirt on all the floors, mud everywhere. I think something on his door got broken.
Yeah, that was a fun one. A lot of stuff was broken. I think stairs, walls, doors.
And I just remember leaving and checking Snap the next day, and there were like holes and stuff in the wall. The couch was ripped open. There's probably an inch of mud covering the entire floor because it rained that day.
Holy fuck, literally, holy.
There were like 150 people in the basement of this house. Upwards of 100, 120 people that show up.
Super fun night though, no one got arrested.
Tristan Ridgeway threw a party, and it was probably like 150 kids, something like that. It's a ton of kids, and I brought a camcorder there and recorded the night, and Nate made a video off of it, and it was amazing.
I'm pretty sure I just crashed my car, bitch. What? I went to Valero and I crashed my fucking car, bro. Roll on, I know shorty and she doesn't want no so-so. Had a man last year, life goes on. Haven't let the thing loose, girl, in so long. You been inside, know you like to lay low. People, what you bringing to the table? Working hard, girl, everything paid for. First, last phone bill, car, no cable. With your phone out, gotta hit them angles. With your phone out, snapping like you Fable. And you're showing off, but it's alright. And you're showing off, but it's alright. It's a short life.
Then we have the creation of Bowman Shed. It's awesome. It's fucking dope.
Where we are right now, pretty sick setup. It's got like a double decker couch in here, there's a TV. There's a bar here now, just kind of like decorations all over the place. We've been using it for storage for the past 3.5-4 years. Eventually I was like, the guys need a place to kind of come hang out, so we cleared everything out. It's pretty sick.
Hello there, the angel from my nightmare. Where are you?
Yeah.
And I'm so sorry. I cannot sleep, I cannot dream tonight. I need somebody and always.
Tommy's house for Super Bowl. That was also awesome. I placed a lot of bets.
And I ended up having a party, actually.
Whenever Jack does not have parents home, he has a party. I apologize to Mr. Brian and Miss Jody.
Oh, Jack's party. Well, Jack's party was fun.
Jack's party? Is that the one he got caught at? Huh? Are we talking about the Jack's party that he got caught?
Yeah, the big one.
There was like 5 people sleeping in the living room. I think 2 people slept in the kitchen. Nate had a blanket and he was sleeping on top of a snowboard, I think.
Lacrosse starts. It feels like the season. It feels like we just had tryouts even though it was about 2 months ago.
Yeah, that's fucking crazy.
Oh, that sucked last year. Lost to Hereford, 5-4. We're not gonna have it this year. We're gonna beat them. That'll be the best play in my life.
About halfway into the season. Season's going good so far. I think, you know, we got a good shot at winning this thing, and I'm pretty excited for the last part of the season. But nothing beats a feeling of popping a top left corner, you know?
You sound like a fucking crack.
We played the teams that we're going to go against in playoffs in the regular season. We demolished those teams. Even Archbishop Curley, probably going to go to States for MIAB. We crushed them. It wasn't even close. So that just shows you the level of like a small 2A school.
Lacrosse, I mean, I don't know. It's supposed to be the year for us, but no, we're definitely going to win. Every time I think about lacrosse, I get chills.
What's up? I'm Mark Rufinock. I'm a senior at Canon High School, and I'm one of the 5 captains on the Canon High School lacrosse team.
I'm Jake Gordonaire. I'm a senior at Canon High School. I'm also one of the 5 captains on the lacrosse team. After last year, getting to the state championship, losing to Hereford by 1, which sucked a lot. Came back this year, we're like, this is our year.
First round, we had North Hartford. It was a chippy game, though, the whole time, even though I think we won 27-4.
Went and played QA. Got to destroy them, which felt great.
Second round was Walkersville. They had this one kid, Garza, Paul Garza. He's going to Navy. He looked ridiculous on film. And
then we played Walkersville, who they had Paul Garza, who's like insane. I kind of strapped him up, though, which felt really good. And then we got to play Hereford. That was awesome.
Going into Hereford, I mean, I was in school and teachers were like, are you okay, Mike? This game meant a lot to us.
I knew at the start of the game I had a little bit of nerves, but I knew if we just stuck to our game plan and did what we do best, we'd have no trouble.
It didn't really fully hit me until we were in the locker room. Someone said something along the lines of like, you win or you go home. Yeah. And I was like, oh shit.
And at the end of the day, we got the job done. Just smoked them 13-3.
So that was state semis, state finals, Huntingtown. We going into the game, we knew that we could beat them even though we were considered the underdogs.
Started off early in the morning when all the boys got dressed up looking nice for school. But the whole time we're dressed up, we got off the bus. We were feeling good going into the locker room.
We got up early, felt great. We let them slip back a little bit here and there, but they never had a lead on us. We had a lead the whole game.
Ended up winning 11-7. Rushing on the field, that was something else. Watching the other guys do it in 2014, 2015, watching them throw their dicks and their helmets.
Seeing everyone gear just getting thrown up in the air and me just sprinting the full length of the field, it was amazing.
I walked up to Jack, I gave him a hug. I was like, we did it. Walked up to Owen, I was like, how's it feel, man? Like, you're a sophomore, you just got a ring. We're standing on the sideline, final seconds are ticking down. Okay, I literally go, Mike, and I pointed at the scoreboard, it goes 4-3-2, and everyone just takes their shit off and just starts throwing it. Dude. One of those things where you can't quite describe it to someone, you just have to experience it for yourself.
Kent Island flies onto the field victorious by the final score of 11-7.
It's the morning of graduation. I just woke up. I don't think it's really hit me yet that we're graduating high school.
What's going on, boys? This is Harrison on the way to graduation. Lacrosse games, soccer games, basketball games, practices, and it's all flowing through right now, and gotta head in. Love you, boys.
It's June 2nd, 2022. I'm graduating high school today. I'm nervous and excited, but mainly I'm just feeling really nostalgic and I can't stop thinking about all the memories I've had in high school. And I don't know, I think I did it right.
For all these years, probably coming to an end.
What's up? Today is June 2nd, 2022, and we're about to graduate. Just woke up. It's about 8 o'clock in the morning. I'm gonna go downstairs, eat some breakfast, and get on the road.
Welcome to graduation.
Hell yeah, dude.
Feeling pretty nice. Celtics in 7.
Celtics in 5.
Celtics in 7.
What's up, it's Nate. It's June 2nd, 2022, also known as graduation day. About 9 hours ago, I walked across the stage of high school and am no longer a senior at Canon High School. Today is also the day that I finished my documentary. My grandmother always told me that everyone's always got a story, everyone's worth listening to, figuring out what they're all about, and I think that this documentary perfectly embodies that. Spent the last 9 months organizing interviews for people, asking them questions regarding their experiences in high school, asking them to tell their stories, spent hours sitting down editing, creating this piece of art in order to recap and remember my senior year of high school. I couldn't be happier with the final product. So it's been the most intensive thing production-wise that I've ever created. And I just hope that everybody enjoys it as much as I enjoyed creating it and experiencing these things.
Let it go. Let it roll right off your shoulder, don't you know? The hardest part is over, let it in. Let your clarity define you.